Now that we know what mock objects are and how to use them, I want to focus on a design decision that we had to take so that we could use the mocks and facilitate the testing. If you remember our previous example, the invoice filter class, the class was going directly to the database to get data and then do some business logic. We then decided that we didn't want to use database to test this class because it was just too much complex and hard to control. We decided to use mock objects. And then what we saw is that the production class wasn't ready to use mock objects. We had to change how it was designed. So instead of instantiating the database class directly, we then received it via constructor, because this enabled us to use mocks during the test and to pass the real implementation when the software runs for real. And this is what I want you to focus right now. We changed the way our production class was working just to facilitate testing. This is actually a very common approach by developers, and this is what we're gonna discuss throughout this video. So just to get a complete example again, in the previous weeks, we had the problem where we wanted to give a specific discount if it was Christmas Day. I have an example of an implementation here. If it's Christmas, then we give 15% of discount. If it's not Christmas, there's no discount. So pause this video and see how I implemented it. And please focus on the way I'm getting the today's date, or in other words, how I am using the calendar class. Okay, so this is the method we want to test. And from the test design perspective, the way the implementation works doesn't affect this that much. So let's do functional testing again, using the category partition method that we saw in the functional testing week. And the idea of this method was to think about all the parameters and the characteristics of these parameters and then do the combinations. For example, the two parameters we have for this problem is the date and the row amount. And the date can be Christmas and not Christmas, and the amount can be positive, can be zero, can be negative as an exceptional case. So we do all the combinations, and then we have all the tests we need to do. So this means in one test, the date will be Christmas with positive number, not Christmas with positive number, so on and so forth. So from the test case design perspective, we kind of don't care how our code is implemented. But then, when it goes to automating the test and write a JUnit test for this, implementation matters. And the way our code is right now, it is not easy to test because, again, if you look, we cannot control how to get the current date. This means whenever I invoke this method, my Java program will get the current date. So there's no way for me to control and say to this method, now I want this date to be Christmas, or now I want this date to be something different from Christmas. We don't have control, and it's going to be really hard if you want to test this. I mean, it doesn't make sense to change the date from my computer to Christmas, run my test, then change the data from my computer to something else again, right? This is too complicated. So what can we do? Or what changes can we do in this class to make sure that this is just easier to test? This is, of course, very contextual and depends on the problem we are tackling. But one simple suggestion is, if you need to control the dates, instead of actually getting the date by yourself, we can receive the date as a parameter of this apply discount method. This gives us more control because now the test method can pass any date we want, and then we can simulate all the different cases we want to do. This is just one very simple approach for this, but there are many other design decisions you can take to facilitate your testing, and this is what we are going to explore in the next videos. What I want you to have in mind for now is that there is a relationship between how you design your code and how easy it is to be tested. So whenever you're implementing something, think about how you can design your production class in such a way that writing an automated test for it is possible and even easier.